there's something very special about these films and the history that they contain. There's a great spirit to them.
It's quite rare that somebody taps into a universal psyche the way that JK is able to.
When I finished Potter, I refused to say never again. No matter how many times in interviews I was asked that question.
These characters, they're born out of Joe's imagination. There's so much color and so much vibrancy.
To be so in awe of a film and then know you get to play in that world soon, it's incredibly magical.
J.K. Rowling is not just continuing a story, she's taking it to a new level.
Are you going somewhere?
No. We're going somewhere.
Jeez.
It's just been a pleasure to come back and breathe life into the character again.
When we finished the first film, I thought, what a gift that we'll get to return to this world. But it still felt like a whole new experience because they've brought in these new, wonderful actors that really take the story in a different direction.
It's more layered, it's more complex, there are more character strands developing.
There's a rumor that Newt Scamander is headed to Paris.
One of the great glories and joys of the Beast series is how free I am to go different places. Of course, it had to be Paris.
Paris is like the perfect tapestry for Joe to really start showing this other world.
There's going to be more magic. There's more magical environments.
And I think you can tell when you watch the movies, we really build this stuff.
And we've got new beasts, as well as revisiting our favorite Botruc and Niffler.
Obviously, the Niffler's back. The Niffler's had babies. There's now an entire family of seed stealers.
Then you have a Kelpie, who's an underwater creature, so I've been learning to dive in order to film with said Kelpie.
The Zuwu is described in Chinese mythology, gigantic elephant-sized cat, five-colored. There's a maledictus. Slowly over time, they are turning into a creature and they can't stop it. Credence has formed a powerful emotional connection with her. Her name is Nagini. These movies have given me the chance to tell a story that I knew all along.
Part of the pleasure of this is obviously connecting back to Harry Potter.
One of my favorite things about the new film is the beginning of the exploration into Newt and Dumbledore's relationship.
If you'd ever had the pleasure to teach him, you'd know Newt is not a great follower of orders.
He's not the fully formed, aged Dumbledore that we all got to see in the Harry Potter films.
If you know this story from having read the Potter books, you will know that Dumbledore and Grindelwald were incredibly close. Dumbledore says he was gathering followers and I didn't challenge him. So why didn't he?
I can't move against Grindelwald. It has to be you.
I think people will be very surprised, having seen the first movie. We're now getting into the meat of the story, and people's allegiances are now being exposed.
Grindelwald believes that wizards should no longer live in hiding.
He's a master manipulator, and that is why he is so dangerous.
The stakes of good versus evil are getting more and more extreme.
The world is splitting, and it's quite fun because you can decide which camp you're in.
Which of these characters will hear his siren call?
The time's coming.
I think it's going to surprise people. Things are becoming much more dark and complicated.
The last one feels like an adventure. This is a thriller.
It's like a ride, like you get to the end and you're like, whoa, what just happened?
It's not like anything we've done before.